My name is Mohammad Zari, and I'm a third-year PhD student at Victoria University, and I study sonic arts. I look at using extra-musical sonic byproducts of industrial technologies in a musical context by building sound sculptures that are inspired by these noises. Victoria has been really supportive from the beginning, for example, by just simply allocating three different supervisors from different departments to support my work. I'm enrolled in the music school, but due to the nature of my work, which requires a lot of practical and technical things, I have access to the facilities of the engineering school and their labs within like a 5-minute walk, which is pretty amazing. And both schools have been really supportive of what I've been doing. And the fact that, for example, the dean of the engineering school takes this time to sit and review all my papers and mark them down with a red pen, I think that's pretty amazing.
I'm Laura Roach. I'm studying at the School of Education at Victoria University, and I've just completed my first year of my PhD. I work with children with profound and multiple disabilities, and I am teaching them to request preferred items using different assistive technology. On a global level, we are providing more literature on different ways that are successful in teaching these children. And on a local level, just the parents who are looking at these children saying, "Wow, I didn't think he could do that. It's awesome." The research quality at Vic is highly regarded throughout the whole of New Zealand and internationally. The Postgrad Association here provides different scholarships that are really helpful in progressing research. Additionally, you can apply for internal funding through Victoria, which last year it sent me to Chicago and earlier this year it sent me to Las Vegas to present research. So they really promote extending your experiences and your research capabilities.
My name's Greg Severinson and I'm studying a PhD in law. My research is around the regulation that we need for carbon capture and storage in New Zealand, which is a technology designed to mitigate climate change by injecting CO2 underground. The doctoral scholarship is really useful in that you can do a lot of hours under the scholarship to contribute to the life of the faculty, so that includes things like teaching, research, collaborating with your supervisor or other academics and producing papers, and that really reflects the nature of the PhD program, which is more like an academic apprenticeship, I think, than just a qualification.
To be able to basically bring to the table what you have in your mind, discuss it freely and casually with your supervisor, that's very important.
Victoria gives a lot of support to its postgraduate students, I've found. The role of the supervisor is really important in encouraging you to think independently but guiding you, so I think it's a delicate balance to be struck, and my supervisor certainly do that well.
My time here at Victoria doing this PhD has been one of the greatest periods of my life. It's really fulfilling to follow what you actually like through an academic position.
It is really individualized work, which has a nice element to it. When you produce your final sort of research, it's all your own work. It's quite a good feeling.
You've got to be disciplined and set deadlines for yourself, because there's not going to be someone always looking over your shoulder to set them for you. But that said, if you're passionate about a subject, then that's its own motivation, and you feel naturally motivated to read and write and think independently.